Hello and welcome to this HIPE tutorial. In this video, you will learn about the structure of a typical Herschel observation. First of all, if you haven't watched the HIPE data internals video, please do so now, because we'll be using the concepts introduced there. Now, I have just imported a full observation, and I have the corresponding variable here in the variables view. A double click opens the observation viewer, let's maximize it, which is made of three panes. I'll close them all and open them one by one. First, you have some summary information, like the object name, position, observation ID, and so on. There may also be a thumbnail image, like in this case. Click it to enlarge, and click again to put it back. Then you have a long list of metadata values. I won't go through them all, but not in particular the obs state entry. In this case, it is level 2 process, which means that this observation was processed successfully all the way to the end of the pipeline. Finally, what I'm most interested in, the data pane. On the left-hand side, you have the components of the observation. If I hover on an element, a tooltip comes up telling me what kind of data this is. The observation as a whole is a context, an observation context to be precise. There are several other contexts inside, like the auxiliary context, the level 0 context, and so on. If I open the level 2 context, I find in this case two products of type spectrometer point source spectrum. If I open one of them, I find two datasets, a spire spectrum composite dataset and a history dataset. The composite dataset contains two spire spectrum 1D items, which are also a kind of dataset. Now, if a product or dataset has an associated viewer, just clicking on it in the tree view will open the viewer in the right-hand side. Click on the arrow icon to maximize the viewer and click again to restore it. You can also right-click on an item and choose either Open to open the item with the default viewer or Open With to choose from a list of available viewers. Whatever I choose, let's try Product Viewer this time, the viewer opens into another tab of the editor view, rather than inside the observation viewer. By the way, a double click on an item opens the default viewer in a new tab, just like a right click followed by Open. Now let's look at the Product Viewer we just opened. It's almost the same as the observation viewer, have you noticed? There is no summary pane, but everything else is the same. Not surprising, since an observation is a context, and a context is just a special kind of product. Now, let's do the same with the composite dataset, and open it with the dataset viewer. Again, similar structure, metadata plus data. Finally, if we open one of the Spire Spectrum 1D datasets, we can see the naked numbers, the columns making up the dataset. Let's go back to the observation viewer now. Whenever you select an item, a strange formula appears at the top of the right-hand area. This is what you have to write in the console view, or in a script, to create a variable containing the item. I click this icon to copy the magic formula to the clipboard. Then I go to the console view. I'll call the variable myspectrum. So myspectrum equals, and then, with the Ctrl V or Command V on a Mac, I paste the formula, and then I press Enter. And there you go, the variable has been created. Another easy way to create a variable is to right-click on an item and choose Create Variable. In this case, however, the default variable name can be quite a mouthful. You may want to click on it to rename the variable to something else, like I'm doing now. This was a spire observation, but packs and hi-fi observations follow the same general structure. Context, then simple products, then datasets, and finally the naked numbers. This is all for now. In this video, you explore the structure of a typical Herschel observation in HIPE. Thank you for watching.